South Korea has raised the alarm on its neighbor's expansion of ballistic missiles. North Korea has strengthened special forces with modernized equipment, making it capable of attacking targets such as Seoul's presidential office. Lim Yun-suk tells us more.
The Defense Ministry released its defense white paper on Tuesday, outlining some of the changes that have taken place in North Korea since its last edition in 2018. It noted that North Korea has expanded its missile brigades to 13 under its Strategic Force Command from 9 units in 2018, and that they are believed to operate short-range ballistic Scud missiles that aim to strike targets in South Korea, also Nodong missiles with a range of about 1,300 kilometers, and also Musudan intermediate-range missiles with ranges over 3,000 kilometers that put the U.S. strategic military bases in Guam within range. According to the document, the increase in the number of such units is in line with North Korea's aim to strengthen its military and other conventional weapons. Now, the communist state has also been carrying out attack trainings by using mock-ups of South Korea's major facilities, including this presidential office. The document says there seems to be no change in North Korea's nuclear stockpiles, with Pyongyang possessing about 50 kilometers of weapons-grade plutonium, enough for about 10 nuclear weapons. And the number of troops in North Korea continues to outnumber the South, with nearly 1.3 million active duty service members compared to 550,000 here in South Korea. Now, despite the fact that North Korea is continuing to build up its nuclear and military capabilities, South Korea does not refer to North Korea as its enemy. And President Moon Jae-in is still hopeful that North Korea's leader Kim Jong-un will come forward for dialogue and that he is willing to give up his nuclear weapons program. Lim Yang-suk, CNA, Seoul.